Hey people, it's part two of my Trader Joe's haul. Oh my god, my lower back is on fire. Oh my god. I need to lay on an ice pack after this. Oh my god, I was like, I probably looks like such a crazy like old woman at Trader Joe's because I was like holding my back when I was walking around the store. People probably thought I was crazy. Honestly, I was afraid I was gonna pass out. Like, anyways, let's just continue so I can actually eat a proper meal and then I won't feel so terribly. Let's continue. Okay, anyways, I always think I want to try to give this some kind of order, but then I remember I don't care. Okay, so then I got these 12 dozen eggs. Why do I always say 12 dozen? One dozen. Because it's 12 and then it's whatever. Yeah, I just got these eggs. Eggs. That's a gross word. Eggs. People, did you see? Okay, on Instagram or like wherever, did you see? This is for if you watch Arrested Development. But there was a, yesterday for Easter, it had a picture of Anne. And she was eating the egg, and I was just like, "Happy Easter egg!" if you guys don't watch that show, you don't get the joke. But basically, Anne loves hard-boiled eggs, and anyways, it's just I want to watch that whole series again. Honestly, people, this is a whole other thing. But honestly, I got up to season 4. You know, the one that they like did for Netflix. And someone told me that it was a terrible season. So I started watching it with that in mind. And then so I never finished it. Should I finish season 4? If you watch Arrested Development, tell me. Because I kind of want to start from the beginning. Because I love it so much. Anyways. Okay. Then I saw this when I was like delirious in the frozen food section holding my back. Like, I think I'm going to pass out. I saw this steamed chicken soup dumplings, and I thought it was interesting because at first I thought it was a soup with dumplings in it. I was like, oh, that's good. But it says filled with a rich and savory broth. So it's like the soup is inside the dumpling. Do you get it? So I was like, the broth is inside of the dumpling instead of the dumplings inside of a broth. I don't know, I thought that was cool. And it's chicken. So it's basically like a pot sticker with broth in it. I don't know, I feel like it's gonna be really good. So yeah, I just got this. Yeah. I'm excited, I never tried it before. Okay, then another thing I didn't try before is another kind of cookie that I've been like staring at but ripping myself away from buying it. For the longest time, it's these chocolate hazelnut cookies, light and crispy cookies made with ground hazelnuts with a creamy chocolate hazelnut center. And look, they're like powdered with like cocaine, just kidding, with sugar. Might as well be my cocaine. I love sugar. That was the thing. I was like, as I was like putting stuff in my basket, I realized, I was like, didn't I just say in the last Trader Joe's haul that I noticed I eat way too much sugar and I should probably cut back? And then have like 4 desserts in my basket. And I'm like, I don't care. No, I do care. But when you're like so starving that you feel like you're going to pass out, you honestly don't care about anything except for food and eating all the food you want. So that's that. But yeah, and they have similar cookies like these, but they're like the cookie butter ones. They're like shortbread sandwich cookies with cookie butter in them, and I never tried them, but I just know that they're so good because Trisha Paytas loves them, and like so many people I know love those cookies. But I don't know, every time I go to Trader Joe's, I never want to get them. Like, I know that they're good, I should just get them, but I just never do. But these ones, anyways, they're probably gonna be good. You know what? Talking about I'm gonna die because I'm so hungry. Let's just eat one. Oh my god, they look so beautiful. Oh my God. They smell so good. They smell like holidays. Like, you know, like holiday cookies. Cool. There's like no powdered sugar on this one. Why are you going to show one with tons of powdered sugar and then the actual cookie has like zero powdered sugar? It smells so good. It reminds me of Christmas. Amazing. Amazing. It reminds me of something. I just can't put my finger on it. It's so good. I gave this cookie 5 out of 5 cookies with tons of powdered sugar on it. You know, like in Titanic with the hand, but on the cookies. Sexual innuendo for these cookies. Anyways, okay, continuing. Look, and this is why I disabled comments on my Trader Joe's hauls. Because of certain types of people in this world. But this is me. Okay, and someone just told me yesterday in my DMs that the reason why they love me is because I'm so unapologetically myself. So you know what? I'm not gonna apologize for anything. Okay, if you don't like me, you don't like my food choices, if you wanna hate me because of what I eat, go ahead, hate me because what I eat. But this is what I eat. Steak, kill me if you want to. Just kidding, don't kill me because I don't want to die yet. But anyways, yeah, I got this beef flank steak. Honestly, I haven't bought steak. I have never bought steak. Like when I used to eat steak, and even when I did eat steak, I never really ate it that much. The only one that I bought, there was a specific kind that I would tell my mom to get me because it had like the less fat in it and it was like thinner. I'm pretty sure it was flank or sirloin or tenderloin. I don't even know, but the one that's like thin and like easy to cook, because I don't like those really thick steaks that like people don't cook all the way. I don't know. I don't like that when they don't cook the steak all the way. That's probably like so many people that do eat meat and stuff. They're probably like, oh my gosh, Michelle, it tastes so good if you don't cook it all the way. But to me, I just get paranoid that I'm going to get worms in my stomach. So anyways, that's what I got because I've been craving steak. I've been craving meat. I've been craving, like, ever since, like, me and Alicia, we went to Koreatown for Galentine's Day. Oh my God, that's a whole story time video. But basically, I had Korean barbecue for the first time. And that meat, I dream about that meat all the freaking time. And you know what? It's good because I work my muscles so hard all the time. And I need something that's heavy duty enough to replenish my muscles quicker and all that stuff. So yeah, and it was pretty expensive, so this means I have to cook it tonight, because last time I bought chicken from Trader Joe's, it was expensive because, you know, they, it's like fancy or whatever, fine quality meats. You know what, I don't even want to get into it, but yeah, cool. Okay, what was I even saying? Okay, then I got some produce. Asparagus. This is also in season right now, in case you didn't know. And I love cooking asparagus like in a pan with oil and like cooking it until it's like the tips are like crunchy. I don't know. That's probably not how you're really supposed to cook asparagus. I don't even know, but it's so good. And then I put like garlic salt on it, and sometimes I put a little bit of Parmesan cheese. So good. But I know some people like hate asparagus because like it smells bad or something. To me, I never noticed a bad smell, but it's good to me. And then I got mild cheddar cheese sticks. These people are just, they honestly are such a good snack, not only for like on the go and stuff, but when I'm just at home, like a midnight snack, like when I'm hungry at night, I just like eat one of these and then I'm good. Plus, dairy helps you when you can't sleep. So, pro tip. And I feel like it does work. I don't know. Then I got, oh, kiwis are also in season. Kiwis are also in season. So I just got this little 1 pound bag of kiwis. The only thing is that I felt like in all the little pounds of bags of kiwis that they had, P.S., this bag was less than $2. That's 6 kiwis. I feel like that's a good deal. Okay, anyways, in all the little kiwi bags, there was like all the kiwis were fine, except there was always this like one mushy bad kiwi. And I was like, oh my God. I was looking through all, like the whole pile, and I finally found one. They're all good. So I can't wait. Ooh, this one's kind of soft though, so I probably should eat this one first. But yeah, I love kiwis. They're so pretty. Like when you cut them, like the outside looks ugly. Let's just be real. But the inside, they're so pretty. Oh my God, I love kiwis. Then I got this little bag of red potatoes. Oh, these. This is the thing that I do when I slice in little circles and I eat them with sour cream. These ones. And I just love making like you mashed potatoes with these. You can make country potatoes with them. I do that when I'm making like a elaborate breakfast for myself. And also, you know what I also do with these? I like chop it up and cook it, right? And then I just like add an egg or two in there, and then I add like cheese and bacon. It's just like a breakfast scramble. And it's good. And it has all the macronutrients in it. It's good. So anyways, cool. Then this bag of avocados, because I just love avocados. And I just, oh, I know why, because I'm gonna make lazy people guacamole, because I got frozen mini tacos, which I will show you right now. Yeah, but PS, I put avocado is good on anything. Okay, I live in California. We go crazy with avocados, and I'm not mad about it. Okay, the only thing I am mad about is that it's extra. It's always extra, and it's annoying because it's like there's a million of them. Why is it extra? They're always in season. Why is it extra? I don't know. Because they just want to make money off of your addiction. Isn't that how everyone is, though? Okay, and then these I showed in my last haul because I buy them all the time. And they're so good. And they're just amazing little dense chocolate cakes. Mini triple chocolate bundt cakes. And I just wish I could just eat a million of these every single day. But then I would turn into a mini chocolate bundt cake. I don't know if I'd be mad about it though. Because I bet you some people would love me more. Anyways, I don't know what I'm saying. I'm deliriously hungry. Okay, then I got this honey cured turkey breast. People, this is my favorite lunch meat. This specific one, honey cured turkey breast from Trader Joe's. Like, and then they have another one from the same brand, Columbus, and it's maple cured honey breast. And I mean, they're both really good, but probably the honey one is my favorite. I love their lunch meat. Oh my good. Kill me. Okay. Don't really kill me, people. When I say that, don't really kill me. Okay. Then now I'm afraid. Now I'm not gonna be able to sleep because I'm gonna think I'm gonna people are out. Whatever. Stop talking, Michelle. Okay. Then they were sampling this. If you guys have never been to Trader Joe's, you should like definitely go because they always sample food. And this is what they were sampling today. It's palak paneer, spinach and paneer cheese seasoned with a bit of curry and chili. It's pretty spicy, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not like usually someone who loves spicy food. I don't love it, but I don't hate it. So I just kind of have spicy food in small doses. But it was really, really good. They're sampling this with this organic jasmine rice. And I've bought this jasmine rice so many times before in the past. It's really good. And like this, it's already cooked. It's just frozen. So it comes in a little bag, and you just microwave the bag with the rice in there for a minute or two. I don't even remember. It's been so long, but 3 minutes. But it's really good. So yeah, I thought that was a good different meal option. You know, because sometimes it's good to switch up what you eat, because you know you get to not only for your own taste buds to, you know, not get bored of the same food, but to have like different kind of nutrients go in you. You feel me? So, oh, I thought the video stopped. Okay, then what am I grabbing? Oh, these mini chicken tacos. Have I ever even showed you guys this in a haul? There was a phase where I bought these like every single week. I was so obsessed with them. They're so freaking good. This was another thing that when I was there one time, they were sampling this with the salsa verde, which I bought one, but then I just looked in my refrigerator just now, and I have a bottle that's like not even finished. So this is the salsa verde. This is not spicy at all, people. Which I'm not mad about. And this, I mix it in with a mashed avocado with some salt. Lazy people, guacamole. But yeah, and then I just cook these in oil until they're so crispy. And oh my god, it's so good. I love this. This honestly is what I look forward to at the end of the day. These tacos with my lazy people, guacamole. And then have my mini chocolate bundt cake for dessert. People, it makes a terrible day like so much better. You don't even know. Anyways, cool. I'm almost done. Okay. Buttermilk pancake mix. People, I bought a box of this like a few hauls ago, and it's so freaking good. And what I love about it is like you can just make it by the recipe on here and just have plain, beautiful buttermilk pancakes, or you can like mix stuff into them. And that was what I was doing for like a whole week. Like every day I was adding like cocoa powder, and then I was adding chocolate chips, and then I was adding like brown sugar and cinnamon. I was like, oh my god. So these are so good, and you can make biscuits with them too, but I just always make pancakes. They're so freaking good. Loves it. Okay, oh my god, I'm almost done. Then I got this gouton. I don't know. I'm saying it French, but it's Italian. It's basically like a really thin cracker, and I bought it to eat with that pesto cheese, and it's that Sardinian parchment crackers with olive oil. So they're like paper thin, and it says, like with the musical notes, it says, also known as carta di musica, music sheets, these paper thin are a specialty found only on the Italian island of Sardinia. In fact, the ingredients in our ultra crisp, ultra thin, and ultra delicious are 100% Sardinian. Once you start with them, watch out. Can't wait! And it says product of Italy. So cool. Cool. Can't wait. Okay, last thing I bought, just maple syrup. I bought this before, like a long time ago, and from what I remember, it was good, but it's 100% pure maple syrup, grade A, amber color, and rich taste. For my pancakes, people, that is everything. Thanks for watching my long ass hauls, and I'm so sorry about my craziness, but I'm deliriously hungry. So, I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace, bunnies, and also later haters and supporters. I need to find a better outro. But bye.